to the wrong people to fulfill our agenda. If Franklin Delano Roosevelt said to A. Philip Randolph, yeah, everything you told me is right. The Negroes need this, the Negroes are suffering that. Now you go out and make me do it. Do you think that having a black face in the White House means that we don't have to make him do it?
That's right.
Who surrounds him? Let me even go up a bit further. I just...
It's all right, look.
Our brother is brilliant. He got a good heart. I think he really loves America and wants to make America better. He wanted to ease the pain between America and the Muslim world. He wants to solve the problem of Israel and the Palestinians. He has the heart to want to make America better. But he's like that camel in the Quran that God warned the people, don't hamstring his camel. They didn't care what God wanted. They hamstrung the camel. Every one of our brothers and sisters that spoke today, we have a right to expect something from our brother. 97% of our people voted for him. Yes, there's troubled asset relief program, but there's post no. There is still racist America between the money being sent down and it coming to those who need it most. If he does not use his bully pulpit to address that, we can fault him for that. But wait a minute. In love.
Everybody say it.
In love.
Say it again.
In love.
One more again.
In love.
Okay, I want to deal with that word. Because love is bigger than some emotional feeling. The word love, you can change the vowel O to I and the consonant V to F. When you have love, real love, you have life. And that's why the scripture says we can tell that we have passed from death into life because we love the brotherhood. Okay? Now, I was with Elijah Muhammad one day, my teacher, and he said to me, brother, you're always talking about love. Define it for me. And I went into my Webster's emotional dictionary stuff, and he said, brother, where there is freedom, where there is justice, where there is equality, there is love and there is life. Our problem is we have been looking to the wrong source to give us freedom, justice, equality, love, and life. O.J. Simpson was charged with murder. And in a court of law with a jury of his peers, he was set free. A lot of folk didn't like that, so they sued him. And he lost in court because even though he was not convicted of murder, they said he's responsible. white folk are rich and powerful, the rich and powerful. Because black folk worked for 310 years as chattel slaves and got not one day's pay. I could call out the rich and the powerful whose riches have been gotten on our backs, but I'll save that for another time. The point is, the present generation of whites did not do this. But the present generation of whites are in their privileged position because of what a former generation of whites have done. Now the question is, a black agenda should be put before them, because if they don't accept the responsibility to clean up this problem, you don't have a lot of time to wait 40 more years for a benevolent white president or a benevolent black president. That day is over. America is facing the judgment of God as we sit around this table. Look at the weather. Look at the world turning down on her. America is bankrupt. $13 trillion in debt. And if you figure Medicare and Medicaid, she's over $60 trillion in debt. She can never pay it. That's why she voted for $650 billion in armament, because she can't pay the debt. But she can bully those whom she is in debt to with fear over her military prowess. I'm here to tell you she's losing there too. Now I close. Our people need repair. We need repair from 310 years of chattel slavery, where black men were forced to be studs, to make black women pregnant, to make more slaves for the slave master. And that same unhealthy attitude of misusing our women and making babies that we have no desire to take care of is still with us. Willie Lynch, who gave the ways that we could keep being divided so that they could rule us for 1,000 years. That sickness is still with us. Yes, we got a black president, but brother said it was confusion. He confused the issue. But really, he never wants to lose the white vote. So if he loses the white vote, he don't care that you voted for him. But if he loses the white vote, he feels he will lose. Dear brother, if you're watching, out of love, you won't lose the white vote of those whites that really understand this problem and know that this problem needs to be solved, and we can't keep relegating it to generation after generation because a few of us got a little money, a few of us got positions, a few of us have wealth, while the masses of our people are going steadily down. No one man can rise above the condition of his people. So President Obama, this august body of brothers and sisters that really love you want you to use your bully pulpit. But then after you do that, then what about us? See, brother said responsibility. Is it that we should let them take responsibility to do for us, or should we pool the knowledge that's at the